normally some silk dress underneath. She would have shalwar. And she's wearing earrings which are probably from the 1930s. This is 1890s, the necklace. And she's wearing the koshtele, which is the wedding, which apparently mimics, see, the shape mimics her eyebrows. Yeah. And Lulu is the most suitable person to wear it.
Yeah.
And she's wearing a gold embroidered cap, which is modern, but it's done in the old design. But she has, in front of her, she has, this is the iniquitous chapshvan. This is the horsehair veil.
Oh, horsehair. Oh, yeah.
And this is original from that time, from the 1910s.
Very stiff.
What is it called?
Chachvan. Chachvan. And they mainly, and she's also wearing a bracelet, which I believe is not very old. It's probably about 50 years old. Also the typical Bukharan work. And the chachvan is a completely Uzbek. It's from Bukhara. Yes, you can see very well.
Yes, you can see very well.
She would wear it with a paranja over it. Yeah. The paranja is a kind of cloak that comes over your head. And she would see quite well, but nobody, you could not see her through it.
Are there dust and sand issues we're dealing with there with these kind of covers on your face, or is it primarily for modesty and cultural?
Modesty.
Last summer, the Kyrgyz group visited us, and they, gave us this as a present. It's one of the things we got. It's absolutely modern, but the form
is classic.
If you will turn around, you can imagine this will be embroidered.
Yes. Yes.
And this is the cover for here. And the same idea of here also. Well organized. The culture which is already organized and the nature turned into culture. This is simple version, but it's still, it's beautiful. And especially with Kazakhs, we're very, very concerned. We don't have this top. We have flat, not only flat faces, but also always try to lift it, because we don't need it. We have these kind of beautiful things that's calm.
She brought with her from part of her family. This is part of the jewelry that we wore.
Actually, originally it was when we got it was supposed to be wear it on your braids.
Yes. Braids. Yeah.
And my uncle brought it to my mom, and because he needed money, and he bought it so my mom would bring it to the museum.
Yes.
She brought it to the museum. The museum bought some pieces, but didn't replace it. And he, some of the pieces he ended up giving to relatives.
Yeah. That's a beautiful piece.
And it's hollow inside, so it makes this ring.
It makes this ring noise.
So when you wear it on your brain, you walk around.
And it frightens away the spirits that inhabit your hair. Yeah.
So it was very cheerful.
In the modern days, would then somebody buy a hat like this and then do embroidery additionally?
Yes. People now really interested. It is everybody can get these basic things and then add something what they have.
This is all the
elements.
The original coral, the orange coral.
These are from 1800s.
Wow.
It's insane.
And it's whitened already. Yes.
How old is that turban
that
you're wearing?
I think that's
it's
modern.
It's modern, last year. I think it was done like made year ago. But it's traditional. But the idea is very interesting. To combine what you have. It's not only like a straight law how it should be created. But if they have pieces like this, they something else and make their own jewelry. Ideas are there, but the